Hey Virgo, welcome back to your weekly reading, weekday reading, what am I saying? This is Kelly from House of Virgo. If you're new, please smash that like button and subscribe. If you want to get a personal reading, I do have a September birthday discount for you on my website, so go over there and book your reading. Happy birthday to you if it is your birthday today. And as always, we keep in remembrance those who lost their lives today on September 11th. And as I'm recording this, it is September 11th. So, all right, let's get going here. Let's see. So we're just gonna take a look at the energy with the person that you have currently on your mind and see what's going on with them and what's going on with you. So you've got self-indulgence, focusing on this, on self. You got the chaser. And well, okay, so that's pretty clear cut. So it looks like Virgo, like while you are in the process of doing you, boo, you've got somebody here who is out of nowhere, out of the blue, sudden change, gonna start chasing after you. can't live without you. Fear of abandonment, coming back around or reaching out. Finally, like having an epiphany, changing. This could be the one. So a lot of questions going through your head this month. Is this the person? Can I trust this situation once again? This person wants to have a heart-to-heart conversation. Tell you about, you know, what they've come to terms with, what they realize. They got sunglasses. They've been watching you, keeping their eye on you, Virgo, for sure. Okay, so yeah, there's definitely a little bit of stalking happening here. This person's gaslighting themselves in a lot of ways. They're telling themselves that you still love them or that you still want them, and maybe you do. They don't know for sure, but they believe that you do, okay? And there is some kind of epiphany happening here with this. At least they will tell you that they're like, oh my gosh, I realize that you are the one for me, and you've always been the one for me, and I trust you, and I don't trust anybody else, and you know, I really want to tell you how I feel. I can't stand being without you. And you know, they've even been indulging in themselves. They'll say they've been doing like healing work, focusing on their self-worth, shadow work, that kind of thing. So you know, I want you to take this with a grain of salt, Virgo, of course. I mean, this is a really good message, but not every message is for you, so keep that in mind, right? So if you've been dealing with someone who's sneaky and a liar, then you might have to go in with like eyes in the back of your head as well. But this message is going in the way where someone here, and it's the exception to the rule, I will say that, but it looks like someone here is really making some hardcore changes. Okay. Putting themselves in a better position, making themselves better, I'm hearing. All right, so I'm going to take a look at them and see what's going on, and I'm going to take a look at you, see what the energy is between the two of you, or like what's going on here. So, all right, Spirit, show Virgo. All right, so this person has the Six of Cups. That's a Scorpio card. Let's take a look. Oh, yeah. Oh, they want to come back. Oh, big time. They want to, they feel lost without you. They want this reconciliation. You make it like, maybe your birthday was September 6th, maybe September 5th. This person, definitely, somebody could be born in 65. This person definitely like sending you some flowers if you still have a birthday, or some belated kind of thing. King of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Okay, I feel like some stuff's going on here. Virgo, what the hell? very, very deep feelings for you. very positive energy. Okay, the High Priestess. So this is someone who's very intuitive. Very intuitive with the emotions. And I feel, Virgo, like they've been keeping this to themselves for a little while. Look, especially their deep feelings about you as well. Could be a Virgo, could be a Pisces. Like I said, that Cancer. They've been doing some serious spiritual reflection, internal seeking enlightenment within. You know, and both of these cards, the High Priestess and the Hermit, are very like isolating cards. They're very much alone. They're not active. They're like trusting their intuition and doing some deep soul searching. I feel like this person is coming in with some serious, look at that, geez, these major arcana. We got Scorpio here with the Death card. Like, really, they've had a transformation. Like, this person has like come to a near-death experience. It may not actually be one, but it feels like one to them. Like a major transformation and change. Yeah, like a rebirth too, right? It looks like they're moving on for some past energy. Okay, moving on from some past energy. Lifestyle change right there. I'm telling you, this person's making huge changes in September. Yep, they've surrendered and cut off all the bullshit or the BS or any other people, or cut out the abusive relationships, cut out their own behavior, if they were like that. And it's really making some huge shifts and changes. So yeah, I do feel like you're going to hear from this person in like for a heart-to-heart conversation. I feel like they're going to try to talk to you. They're hoping that you'll listen, but what will you do, Virgo? Let's see. Wow, I feel like you'll be very happy about this. Yeah, you'll be willing to listen here, okay? You've got the King of Pentacles, the Nine of Cups, Queen of Pentacles, so that's masculine and feminine. Oh gosh, Virgo, like this is gonna make you so very happy. Whoa, of course, you're like, you never let them go. Looks like this is with that devil energy. That toxicity, that toxic energy, this, I don't know if it's like some type of like physical attraction to this person is insane. Oh, it's so insane, like bound to one another. The sexual lust, the addiction, Jesus, right? Yeah, Virgo, I feel like you want this to happen. You want this person to have like these amazing changes. I feel like you want to be in union, happily ever after. This, you feel like this is your person. You've maybe have always felt like this could be the one, but I don't know what happened between the two of you. But something here where it looks like this person is coming in with major shifts and changes. Capricorn, Cancer, Taurus, another Virgo. Look at this. Progress and reconciliation and progress. And a new love start. Virgo, this is really positive, I have to say. This is like a gift, a blessing. I feel like you want this. I feel like you're going to be open. This will be a wish come true for you to have this person finally like surrender and want to talk to you and open up and tell you what they've been thinking. And I do feel like they're going to do that. And they come and they're chasing after you. I feel like this person, either they're feeling like they're close to their deathbed or whatever, and they just don't want to live their life without you. This is what I feel like this message is. Let's see what their hidden truth is. Because I really feel like this person truly does love you. Okay, I'm starting to understand our connection. I know I messed up everything. Wow. Okay, I wish things could be different. I feel like whatever the differences are between you and this person, they wish they could be different. They want to make them different. They wonder if you're happy without them, that's for sure. Oh, you speak to me through music, so there's some kind of songs or something that they hear that they're listening to. It's really helping to enlighten them or wake them up. So many things remind them of you, Virgo. Like everywhere they go, they walk down the street, they see a tree, and they're like, hey, there's Virgo. You know, or they see a rock. Hey, it's a Virgo. I'm just being funny. Let me have my fun, damn it. Yeah. A raccoon. Hey, it's Virgo. Okay, Virgo, they love you. They love you. This person really, they want to be able to take back their words. A little, some apologies coming in. I mean, I feel like this is something you've been wanting. The whole time you haven't heard from them, they've been burying themselves in work to forget you. Didn't work. Not working. Not working. hide behind material things. Well, okay. I feel you leaving me behind. This person is like dying. This person is absolutely... I hid who I really am from you. There's so much they want to say. And they know that you will be together again. And they're going to make that happen. I feel like this person is going to come in and try to like work things out here. Try to get you guys like to have... They just want to talk to you, Virgo. And if you want to give them that opportunity, it looks like you will. It looks like you'd be very excited to hear things that are going to be productive to change. You know? For sure. Okay. Yeah, so it looks really positive. I feel like this person, they just can't, like, there's a new love start. There's healing for sure. But more than anything, I mean, yes, this person does love you, but more than anything, they don't want to live their life without you. They are a wreck without you. They feel alone, isolated, away from their other half. You are their other half, and they completely feel like just empty. There you go. You know, when I was saying they're your other half, I thought immediately, I said, this has got to be a twin flame relationship. And there's a twin soul card. There it is. Communicate your love to the divine. Be thankful for this twin soul love. You've been chosen for one another, even when times are tough and seem back and forth. This love was meant to be, and it's time to reconcile. So that's the energy that's playing out going forward. Before the end of September, for sure. Maybe even going a little into October, but it is time. You and your twin. There is going to be a conversation. And I feel like you will be very happy to reconcile with this person to hear what they have to say. Yep, justice is served. And this is a message for you, Virgo. Remember that thing that you were sweating over? Well, that's coming to an end. You're in a good place now because a verdict is delivered in favor of you. The truth is coming out, making things right. This universe is making this right. It's not necessarily this person. I mean, they're playing a role. But universe is like, all right, it's time. It's time for Virgo to get that good karma. And the universe is going to make things right, reflect. So... it's interesting because I saw that card and then I stuffed it back in here and started shuffling again. It showed up again. That's the Hermit. So this is an energy of, so we do have, I will say, Virgo, Gemini, and Libra. Go into your cave for a while, Virgo. You need to regroup and recollect. A lot is going on and you need some alone time. Stay in the stillness and the quiet, but don't get lost. Tell people you're taking a vacation or just pull out for a little bit. You're going to need a recharge because this is going to shock you. This energy coming in from this person, it's going to floor you, and you might just be like, help, I'm not falling and I can't get up. Because that MFer just threw me for a new one. I don't even know what the hell's going on. Somebody help me up. Oh my God, now I'm seeing that old lady laying on the floor. My God, that was a devastating commercial. Help, I've fallen, I can't get up. Like, what? It was most impactful, wasn't it? What was it? Med Alert or something? Okay, you got good news about money coming in. That's awesome. You got a girls' night out coming to you very soon. So take it. Go have fun. You also have your love offer coming in, which I feel like we already knew about. And a loving older female or male. So that is a Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. There's a gift coming in too, so you might be receiving a gift for your birthday from this loving older water sign. Let's see, maybe a belated kind of thing. Victory, recognition, and applause, which is good. Financial loss in reverse, which is perfect. So there's a recovering of your money. And there's also an element, oh look. Victory, recognition, applause, other people supporting this new love beginning. I feel like it's so magical. I feel like a lot of people around you who know about this relationship are going to be really happy to hear that this person and you are going to reconcile and get back on a really, like, even better footing. Like, really happy, like, wow, like Harry and Sally. Remember when Harry met Sally? Like, you know, if you could think of like a couple who are just meant to be, I don't know, Mickey and Mallory, hey, take it however you want, right? I mean, love is love, right? If you're going to go out and going to Thelma and Louise, I mean, I don't even know, whatever you're doing, whoever you can think of, the ultimate couples, that's you and this person. Bonnie and Clyde, let me see. You can do this, Virgo. You have courage and strength to withstand the situation. Go with kindness. It's the strongest attribute you'll ever have. Fight back by not fighting. Pull your courage up from the ground and hold steady. You are a winner. So you're looking good, Virgo. Looks like you're going to get what you want. Your wish is coming true with that Nine of Cups up here. Definitely. This is a wish come true for you. Something that you may have been hoping and praying about. Wishing. Let's see what their Chinese sign is. You and this person. Chinese sign. All right, ear of the dog. Okay, let's see. Year of the ox. Year of the goat. Year of the tiger. Year of the rooster. Year of the pig. Year of the dog. I already said that. Year of the monkey. Double monkey. Year of the snake. Okay. So just remember my disclaimer, you know, if this person that I'm talking about here in this reading, you resonate with this, and this person has been in and out of your life with the same old, oh, I've changed, this is not your reading, because that's someone who's just apology with no action is manipulation, okay? And if even if they only, like, when somebody is seriously sorry, like, the remorse is through the roof. Okay, and they never let you forget how sorry they are, and they just keep making it up to you for the rest of their life because the guilt or the remorse is so so immense, you know. And if somebody is making changes and they're trying, and it's the first time, and you really love this person, then you got to give them the opportunity to show you that they're making changes, not just words. Anybody can do lip service, not just words, but actions behind words. If you want this to work, you have your participation part is giving them the opportunity to prove it. You have to let them, right? So let's see. Let's get to the good stuff. Let's get some initials or names and see what comes out here. Initials or names for Virgo. Oh, they just gave me some tennis rackets. So I don't know if somebody plays tennis. Or is going to be wearing tennis rackets on their shoes in snow. What are those things called? All right, let's take a look here. All right, we have Val, Valerie. I'm picking up Val or Sal. Paul, Pauline, Paula. All right, somebody's going to be a vampire for Halloween, I think. We've got Kay, K-A-Y. Okay. Faulkner. I'm just hearing fuck. Or somebody wants to fuck. I want to fuck you. I said fuck, not the other word. Okay. Luke. Picking up a Luke. Okay. I just heard somebody just turned on a lamp or turned off a lamp. Somebody has a lump. Okay. Lopper. I just said Lopper. Fala. F-A-L-A. Fala. Okay. And, or Falala. Pia. P-I-A. Pia. They're telling me flip. Flip. Okay, so we've got the letter E, the letter F, the letter P, letter I, the letter H, letter A, two I's. We've got the letter Y, the letter V, the letter U, two A's. Okay, so those are some names. I also heard Nan or Nancy. Nay, Nay Nay, someone's Nay. Someone called Renee or Nay, I'm hearing. And I just heard Fred or Frederick. Okay. Let's see if we can get some numbers, birth dates, all that good stuff, ages. See if I call you out, then this is definitely going to be a reading for you. All right. Someone's born in 1970. Someone is born in 59. Someone is, okay. Let's see, 1989. Someone's born in 1989. 1974. Okay. 1986. All right. 1961. Okay. All right. Someone is 51. Someone is 41. Someone is 36. Someone is 47. All right. August 28th. September 12th. September 21st, September 17th, September 4th. Significant birth dates. Okay. Let's see. August 30th. Somebody is going to be 50. We have the age 45. 49. September 3rd. Sorry, Steve, I'm mixing this all up. 36. September 9th, 14th, and 19th. Okay, do we have any August, any other August birthdays? Oops, sorry. Okay, August 31st. Okay, August 27th. All right, age 55. I'm also picking up, okay, September 10th, September 2nd. Let me give you some four digits of a phone number, 3514-3127, 5542, all right, area code 21021, okay, okay, 2448, and 1968. Okay, it could be the year you're born. Give me a couple of significant months. Okay, someone's born in April and someone's born in November. Very significant. It could be Aries, Pisces, Aries, or November would be Scorpio or Sagittarius. Okay, let's see what, oh. It just said give November birthday and April birthday. Oh, November 3rd, April 3rd, November 7th, April 7th. Hey, that was my dad's birthday. Okay, November 9th and April 9th. All right, signs. Okay, Gemini, Sagittarius twice, and Aries. Your person, Leo, Taurus, Capricorn, Sag, again, your person, signs, Aquarius, a lot of Sag keeps showing up, Aries, and Taurus, one more, your person, sign, zodiac sign, Scorpio, Virgo, Cancer, and Aries. Okay, let's get your charms and see what charms you have. So like I said, there was a tennis racket, okay? So either someone plays tennis, could be professional, or just plays tennis in general, likes to play tennis or has tennis rackets, can be hanging on their wall, maybe has a favorite tennis player. All right, let's see, Virgo. Okay. I have a tremendous amount of charms. Look at all these charms. All right. Ooh, you've got an owl. Awesome. Ooh, hoo. How many licks does it take, Virgo? How many damn licks? See, I don't lick lollipops. I just bite right into them. Because I'm not like, I don't have the patience to be sitting there licking a lollipop. No, just give me the whole candy, crunch it, eat it, I'm done. On to the next. So you've got an owl. Someone might be, an owl could be their favorite animal. This is obviously wisdom, and this is the owl that can turn, like, listen, this is a message. You know how the owl can turn his head all the way around, eyes in the back of the head? I warned you about that in the beginning of this reading. So don't take this message and be like, oh, my person's finally changing. Like, if this person has been in your life many times before, that they were like, oh, I've changed. And this is just them coming back around to the same old BS. You need to know when to draw lines in the sand with people, okay? So for some of you, that's a message. For others, this is just like someone has gained, they totally gained wisdom, okay? They've realized that's what the high priestess is. That's that wisdom, that inner wisdom and knowledge, okay? So this is significant for someone regarding the owl. Let me see, what else do you have? All right, you also have a dolphin, playful energy, protective. Dolphins, I always say, are like the angels of the sea. Dogs are like the angels of the earth, I always say. Very protective energy. So Neptune vibes I'm picking up, Pisces, that water energy as well, Scorpio, Cancer, you know, all the creatures of the sea. Although scorpions are not creatures of the sea, but they do kind of look like lobsters, so distant cousins maybe. I feel like Scorpios, I feel like they could be creatures of the sea, but they're like, if they are, they're like down in the Mariana Trench. Like they're like areas deep in the ocean that you can't even see. There's probably a scorpion down there somewhere hiding under like a trench or a rock. But yeah, dolphins are significant for someone, for you or someone you might know. This is all about the playfulness and joy and protection that's surrounding you at this time. All right, Virgo, so I'm going to leave those messages there. I hope that you enjoyed that. I'll be back tomorrow with another reading for you. Maybe we'll look at who's watching you. And yeah, don't forget to, if you want to join my OnlyFans, I upload a weekly reading there every Monday. So there is one up there, brand new for the week ahead. And it's pretty spicy. So keep yourself together when you listen to that reading. You might need a towel and I don't know. You're going to be sweating. Let me just tell you. So, all right, you guys, thanks for being in the chat. I just want to give a quick shout out to the moderators for your awesomeness here on my channel. You guys do such great work and you're also friendly to everyone. And I'm super excited. I pop in sometimes and I see every time someone new becomes a member or just comes in and hasn't been here before and says hi, the moderator is always like, hey, how's it going? Welcome. And I love that so much. That's a great community you guys are creating here, and I'm so happy for everybody and glad to be able to have a chat for you guys there. So yeah, as far as birthdays, September 11th, you know, I had it on my phone and I don't know what's going on with my iPhone. I think my battery is just like, every time I update it, just is gone. The battery just dies more. So it's dead again. So I can't wish you a personal happy birthday, but I'll try to do it tomorrow when my phone recharges again, okay, when I make another video. But again, if you have a birthday today, happiest birthdays, I wish you a wonderful day, and I will see you all back here tomorrow, okay? Love each other, love yourselves, be happy, take care, bye-bye.